So, Gruff, you are a minotaur in the far-off town of Raekwon.
You suck up, you.
Ruled over by a great titan.
A great titan?
A great titan. I haven't decided his name yet, but it will probably...
A titan?
A titan is the leader of this town.
We're fighting a titan?
You're not fighting a titan. This is just some backstory.
We're fighting a titan shot.
It's a great arena that all of the demi-human residents go to enjoy the blood sport. You are a slave. You were probably captured at a young age. You've been
Ryan,
raised.
That doesn't make sense.
What doesn't make sense?
I have a 70% chance to bend bars.
Okay, well...
Who is going to enslave me? I do plus 9 to damage. Who could possibly enslave me?
A titan? A titan could enslave you? Well, you can bend the bars once the game starts, but for now, you are a gladiator in this arena in the town of Raekwon.
Fine.
We are starting play in the cells beneath the arena, and you are scheduled to fight.
What am I scheduled to fight?
You don't know yet. But you probably have 10 minutes before the next fight starts. Any more backstory you need to tell me?
No. He keeps his personal life close to the chest. Doesn't really like to talk about it.
All right, team chat. All right. This is a town mostly of demi-humans. You get a lot of tomatoes and shit thrown at you because you're ugly and you have horns.
I thought this was mostly demi-humans. Wouldn't they understand?
By demi-humans, I meant like humans, dwarves, elves.
Yeah, I know, but they understand being different.
No, they throw tomatoes at you.
Fuckers. Right.
So, I'll draw this. Do you have the Roll20 app?
No, but I can open it.
Want me to send you a link?
No, it's good. Roll20.net?
It is not a rape dungeon. It's just a regular dungeon. Yeah, Roll20. Dicing with Death.
Ryan version. Hello. All right. Put me against the Hobgoblin. Ooh. Serdolect just subscribed. Show some dragons for Serdolect.
Woo. Playing a dangerous game, dear. Okay, fine. He's in a rape dungeon. But he does the rape.
He does the rape?
And not with his penis, with his axe. Or whatever weapon it is.
So, you mean it's a normal arena, then?
Yes.
Okay.
Have you...
I immediately bend the bars on my...
Are you in Roll20 yet?
Yes.
Okay.
I would like to say to the DM that bend bars is like bars on a gate. If I'm just trying to break a shackle, like a chain links are much easier to break than a bar would be to bend. Wouldn't you say?
You're not shackled. You are in a cell with bars, a barred cell, like a jail.
Oh, okay, I want to go
it's
bend.
It's comfortable. You've got cushy cushions, and they bring you women and food from time. Yeah.
Then why am I behind bars?
Care for it. Because you're a minotaur.
Fuck it, I bend the bars anyway, and then I'll just sit in my area. I just want them to know that I can leave whenever I want to leave.
Sounds good.
Okay, do you want me to roll it in Roll20?
Yes, please. Or just so the chat can see. Do you have? It's not set up on the overlay yet.
Oh, yeah, I'm setting it up on the overlay. Damn it, Roll20, you did... They title their pages wrong, or... No. The HTML headers on their pages are all making sense, which then means OBS doesn't do them well. Grumble, grumble, grumble. Technology, grumble, grumble, grumble.
Titan should be named RZA. He can be GZA? GZA? All
right, there we go. Rolling D100. And 55. I've successfully bend the bars.
Okay, you are able to shred your bar. Can you take a look at the map for me?
Yes, I'm looking at the map.
You are in that cell over there. You break it out, and there's a hallway leading left and right. To the left, you know that there are stairs up to the arena. To the right is a maze of labyrinthine tunnels.
Oh, that's great. I'm a Minotaur. I'm immune to mazes.
Are you fucking kidding me?
No, I'm not fucking kidding you. That's one of the Minotaur racial abilities, is that they're immune to mazes.
You are correct. You are correct.
Broken! I immediately go right.
Yeah, I already drew the arena.
I immediately go right. I want to go into the maze. That's what I call it to me.
From behind you.
I glance over my shoulder.
You hear it coming from this cell up here.
Okay. I walk over. What's in the cell?
Inside you see a insect humanoid with six limbs. You've recognized him from the training grounds, but you don't necessarily know him.
Oh, hey, you. What's your name again?
You can call me RZA.
RZA. RZA the Drizza.
Let me out of here, you old dirty bastard.
In exchange for what? What do I get out of this deal?
He produces a sack, a small coin pouch, and shakes it. Not a small coin pouch, a large coin pouch.
Done. I try and bend the bars.
It looks like a couple pounds of coins. All right, so roll bend bars. All right, so you free this.
Sweet.
Okay, you have your weapons. For a fighter, and they let you play with them and sharpen them at your will.
Sweet. I suit up, and I say, hey, come with me to this maze.
I drew the arena. I didn't draw the maze.
You told me there's a maze. I want to go into the maze.
Okay, you solve the maze, and I don't need to draw it.
All right, where does it end? What's at the end of the maze?
You...
A plus five Nodachi?
What?
A plus five Nodachi?
No, it's just like a labyrinth of tunnels where the jail cells are located underneath the Colosseum. And you pop up at the surface. There's another gate that is locked, and there are two guards on the other side of it. This is like you see sunlight coming through. This is the exit to the outside world.
Oh.
Turn, shout, how did you get out? Isn't that the Minotaur?
Who says that?
Bastard, schedule the fight in 5 minutes.
Who says this?
They're on the other side of the bar. Of the bars.
They're human, elf, what race are they?
Human, wearing leather armor and broadswords and shields.
Okay. I walk up to the humans and remind them with a gruff and a huff and a bending of the bars in front of them that I am 7'4", 300 pounds, and just rippling with muscle.
Why don't you roll a bend bars?
10.
Ten.
My chance is 70%. Even at a minus 60% chance, which would be ridiculous.
I'm looking at imagery links in chat. Great dungeon. Mwahaha. So they were originally holding their ground, but once you bend the bars, their resolve fails, and they take a couple steps back. Do you have your...
How do I get to... I just look at him. What's the fastest way to the arena?
He points back down where you came from.
Through the maze?
You knew that your cells were located right next to... So if you look at that map, that staircase led to the arena. And the maze led back out to the town. You were supposed to walk up the staircase in 10 minutes for your fight, and you broke out and...
I just want them to know what they're dealing with here. You know that I can bend whatever bars I want. Society can't hold me back, man.
So they haven't said a word since you ripped through the bars, and they're just sort of quivering in their boots.
Yeah. All right. I turn to the Threakin, and I put out a hand to shake, and I say, I feel like we will be good friends.
Yes. So, okay, sorry. So you got a pouch of 100 gold. I don't give a fuck.
Sick. Sick.
Okay, and he shakes you your hand with one of his four.
I say,
bars trapped.
I said my name's Gruff, but my friends call me Maverick.
I'll just call you Old Dirty Bastard.
I think you'll just call me Maverick.
Maverick it is.
All right. So I got to go fight these guys, but it was nice meeting you. I'm going to go back into the maze.
I think I was scheduled to fight too, but...
Are we fighting each other?
Opportunity to escape. I may be seeing you.
All right. And I proceed back down the maze.
Now, you think you were both scheduled to fight the fight something together.
Oh, no.
You've freed the Threakin, and he, I don't know, slips past the guards, perhaps. Okay. You don't know. You walk back down through the maze.
Fuck it. I'll do it on my own.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. Okay. So you walk up the staircase, or you walk down through the maze, back past your cell?
Yeah.
Up the staircase?
Yep.
The staircase leads to a gate, which is open. Do you see me pinging which gate?
Yes, I do.
This is the lower level of a circular arena. Each of those squares is 25 feet. Yeah, so it's like 400 feet across. So I can change. Do you want me to change the scale, or can you just multiply everything by five?
That's fine. $1 from the olive. Neil accidentally steps on a Naga baby.
Are we at the point where... chat can change things?
That's up to you. The chat, you're not supposed to be able to change things in this campaign. But if Ryan wants to let you change things in this campaign, then he can. But
let's, like, keep track of it. I'm okay with that. But we'll that, see.
Yeah, we're going to do a separate, different one-shots campaign with chat where you can do that shit and get away with it.
I don't know what a Naga baby... Why would you step on it? This is a reference to misclicks, right? That I don't get.
But sometimes they just say ridiculous things, dude.
Okay. Anyway, so as you're walking up the stairs, there's a guard right there, and he's sort of quivering at your presence. He says, you're late, sir. Get in there quick. And he points up the stairs.
I look at him. The only thing I'm ever going to be late to is my own funeral. And then I stroll up the stairs casually.
Okay. You walk up the stairs into this grand arena. Met with the cheers of the crowd. There must be thousands in the stands.
I survey the stands, and I raise my two nodachis in the air and go,
Alright, across from you are four goblinoids.
Mm-hmm.
This gate is now closed, but they are standing in front of it.
Okay. Covering
their boots. Let me switch to the token layer. Can you draw yourself a token?
Yes. Pineapple juice. Delicious.
Make us pie.
Make us pie.
Okay. The guard fails his save and wets himself. Says the chat. You see him pissing himself as you walk past him. Can you shift the camera up and to the right a little bit so we get the whole arena?
Yeah, I'm just drawing my minotaur.
Chat, you are the audience in the arena. Raise your baguettes. Are you drawing a token or something?
Yeah, I'm drawing myself. Chill out. It's coming.
This interface is stupid. I love it. Okay, so there's four goblins over there. Each of the green... So the green squares on the side are gates, like the one you came in. The green squares on the ground are trapdoors.
All right.
Okay. So the goblins are each armed with... Whatever goblins are armed with. I think little short swords.
Sure.
Assorted weapons that deal D6 damage. And they are quivering in their boots. They do not approach you. What do you wish to do?
What did you say? What was the determination about strength bonus to hit on thrown weapons? Do you get it?
I think you get the strength. I think you get it. Do you get the hit? I think you get it to hit and damage.
You get damage for sure. Do you also get hit?
I don't know. I don't know.
Well, you're the DM. Make it up.
God damn it. Should the DM look it up?
You make it. No, make it up. Make it up.
Let's make it cumulative.
Cool.
Get strength to hit as well as missile adjustment dex. I don't know. Okay. So, what do you wish to do?
I reconsider my life choices and think I should have specialized in dart.
Minotaur dart specialist?
Yeah.
That would be broken as well. We can make that character later, maybe.
Yeah. Maybe it'll be his twin brother.
Goodness, aren't you?
Uh-huh. I don't...
Badass.
Mm. So I take my two Nodachis, yell to the crowd, stick them down to the ground, pull out three darts, and roll for initiative.
Alrighty.
I need to roll here. Sorry. I have dice ready and everything.
Oh, yeah. Why am I rolling? And I can just roll here.
Nine. So the bullshit.
You
got them
the first, but they hold their action. Are you strutting across?
No, I strut across to the point where I am.
What's the range? Each of these squares is 25 feet.
It is two squares, so 10 feet according to the combat and tactics, but the combat and tactics, when you convert to feet, does not match the player's handbook. Well, they're two different...
Handbook.
What?
Then look in the player's handbook.
Darts aren't in the player's handbook.
They aren't?
No.
So let's make it 10 yards. I think is what... That's... Yeah. 10 yards.
Sure. Okay, yeah, so 10, 20, 30, like a dagger. Makes a lot of sense. Okay, so I walked within 10 yards, if I can.
So that's like right there. Right there.
Yeah.
Very short range.
All right, I have movement rate 12. Can I do that? 12, I can move 120 feet in a round. I can move 120 yards in a round, but I incur attacks of opportunity and get a penalty on my surprise. So
none of them have missile adjust or missile weapons.
Okay. But these are 25 feet, so 25, 50, 100, 2. Oh, yeah, so I could easily go. All right, I can move a full move.
I've got it fixed. 120. So you can only, you can't move within range, short range this round. You can move there and attack, and there and make one and make half attacks.
No, I'll move all the way up in a jog.
Okay, and incur an AC penalty.
Yeah,
I think you. I don't think you can make missile attacks if you do that.
No, I can't. I'll just get within missile range
and then attack next round.
Yeah, because they're holding their attacks, so I just walk up to them.
The goblins are holding their attacks. You see a pike stick through the bars of this gate and prod... Damn it. Prod this goblin in the butt. No damage, but just prodding them forward. Just
poke them, yeah.
Yeah, so next round, roll initiative. Ooh. So that one goblin does come at you.
The 11.
You don't... Okay, yeah. They go for... Okay, I thought the 9 was your initiative. Sorry.
No.
11 was your initiative. So he comes... He attacks you.
Okay.
So he rushes at you with his little goblin-y weapon. G-A-B-C-D-E-F goblin. Okay. What's your AC?
16. Or 4, depending on how you want to read it.
Okay, he misses you with his short sword, and he is now in melee range. It is your turn. He shouts something in Goblin back. Do you speak Goblin?
No, I speak Common and nothing else.
Okay.
I would like to throw my dart at him, which does incur an attack of opportunity against me.
Alrighty. You said your AC was 16?
Yes, sir.
He misses.
I throw my dart at the Goblin. So that's going to be RD 20 plus 4. 24.
Critical. Double critical. Cool. Yes, it clears by 10.
Do I get... Well, you know, high ground would be from melee, not missile. Okay. Okay, so R... 3d3 plus 9.
It doesn't matter. He dies.
I get my other two attacks at the end of the round?
You do indeed.
Okay. Do the other guys do anything?
Oh, damn it. No.
D20 plus 4. 20 on a natural 16 and a 7. So D3 plus 9 on the goblin who only has up to 7 HP.
What's a crit clear by 8 if it's not a natural 20? Or not?
10.
Clear by 10?
Yeah. By 5 if it's 18 or higher, and then just double if it...
Okay. No. It does... No. So just
regular. Whatever. Just 11 damage to the goblin.
Okay. He dies. All right. You get... Okay, those are the two more attacks. Okay.
Yep.
There is a press box. Somewhere like here. And from up there you hear a shout, "Release the hounds!" Alrighty. So the two goblins come to close, and let's roll initiative again.
I don't see the gates open or see any hounds, do I?
Not immediately. Roll initiative first and declare.
Well, hold on. I need to know how the goblins are 10 yards away from me. That's 30 feet away from me. So I can gore them with a charge attack if they are 30 feet away from me.
You can charge.
I just want to make sure I know the exact uses of my charge. Minotaur headbutt.
He deals plus 9 damage because he has high strength, and strength applies to thrown missile weapons.
Yep. Not shot like a bow or a crossbow, though.
Just you can get specially made bows.
You can.
Account for your high strength.
Okay. In this case, I will just do my normal dart attack. D10 plus 2. 12.
Well, all right, you go after the goblins who approach you. And attack you with their little goblin sticks. Oh, what's your AC?
16.
Bastards can't crit you.
Nope.
So there's one hit for 4 damage.
Oh.
And then you go. You can, and you hear a creaking from back there.
I want to throw a dart at one of the goblins.
Are you backing up to do this? I assume to not provoke opportunity.
If I back up, will I still be able to get both attacks in?
Oh shit! Technically, you're right.
No, then I'll stay in place.
How much HP do you have?
Max of 10, so I've got 6 remaining.
Yeah.
It's possible that I die right here, right now.
Yeah.
Because if they're both within melee range, then they both get attack. They both get a attack of opportunity on me when I throw.
You wish to do every, but they only get one attack per round. How many?
You can only get one attack of opportunity on a given target in a round.
Okay. You can do that.
Yeah, I'm gonna do it.
Both misses with their attacks of opportunity.
Natural 1.
Saber's death.
11 is a fail.
That's not that bad of a fail. You slip and prick your finger. You take no damage, but you spend the rest of the round sucking on your thumb.
I lose my...
Your 2 attacks.
What?
Pull a Neil, put this thumb.
I lose 2 attacks for barely failing a save? All right.
All right, you can get one of the attacks.
Thank you.
You recover in time.
10.
Miss.
Oh, they have leather armor on?
They have goblin-y armor on.
Goblin-y armor on? Okay.
Gives them AC, they have AC6, apparently. I don't know what they wear that gives them AC6, but that's how it is in the Monster's Manual. It's like 6 with a 10 in parentheses. So they're wearing...
Yeah.
It's pretty intense, actually. That's like... It's like a ring
that's nail. That's studded leather with a shield.
Oh, okay. So they're wearing shields.
Yeah.
Shields and little pokers. Roll initiative.
Okay. I'm just going to go retrieve my sword. My swords.
Okay.
So D10 plus 6 for my large size.
Okay.
11.
They go first. Both misses. The creaking has stopped. Do you wish to turn and see what's going on?
As I walk backwards towards my swords, I will give it a casual glance.
Where did you leave your swords?
I told you, I stabbed them into the ground back here.
Oh, you're dumb. Okay, I didn't realize that. Okay, so move your character. Okay, so the goblins miss, and then you can move. So yeah, I guess you're walking back. You see three wolves coming out of this pit, each on a leash held by a goblin, and then there's a third goblin, or fourth goblin behind them, with no wolf on a leash.
Well, I yog back to my swords and pull them from the ground and face the wolves and flex my muscles.
So you retrieve your swords, but you do not get... Damn it. Wolf. Okay, you retrieve your swords.
All right.
But next round.
Okay. RD 10 plus 8. 15.
Goblins are slow, so they don't reach you that last round. Okay, hold on a sec. You roll 15. Ouch. I think you're going to go last. I don't think there's a way they can even have that. They can even be that slow.
If wolves are size medium, that's impossible for them to be that slow.
Yeah. Wolves are size small.
Okay. Really?
Yeah, wargs are size medium.
I'll be damned.
There's dire wolves that are large, but that would be, they're actually not that much better, are they? So. Alright, this goblin and wolf pair takes a step to you. So does this one. Doesn't close, but moves in. And the goblins let the wolves off of a leash and issue a command as the two wolves charge. Both missing you with bite attacks. It is your turn.
I get two, one in each hand, so they will occur at the exact same time. So d20 plus 5, 4 for strength, 1 for specialization. 16 against a wolf.
Alright, that'll do it.
RD10 plus 11. 15 damage to the wolf.
Ooh. The wolf takes a grievous wound but is still standing. This is a pretty big wolf.
I give it a look of approval, and then I swing my sword at its companion. I shall spare your life this round, noble creature. 23, natural 18.
That is a crit.
R2...
Needs a clear by 10 to double crit?
Yes.
That's a double crit.
R3d10 plus 11. 34 damage to the wolf.
Okay, you slice this wolf in two, and the audience cheers. Cheer, audience. Cheer. I don't see them cheering yet.
There's a 45-second delay.
Okay.
It's the... In medieval times, light didn't move as quickly, so you wouldn't see or hear the audience move until after, you know, some time passed.
Okay.
How is damage so high? We're breaking the system. We made characters intentionally broken.
So you're using a Nonochi, right? Which does D10 damage versus small, medium creatures.
I get plus 9 for strength, plus 2 for specialization.
Okay. So, next round. Let's roll initiative.
12. Ooh.
You... What is the initiative of a small creature?
Medium is 3, small is 3, tiny is 2.
Okay. You go at the same time.
I make 3 attacks. 2 now, 1 at the very end of the turn.
These goblins approach. This wolf gets left off its leash, and it charges that goblin and bites him in the ass.
Well,
right, so wolves and two goblins are attacking you.
The wolf that I hit already, he continues to attack me. No morale check for seeing his brethren ripped in half and having been grievously wounded.
That's good on morale check. Okay, he cowers and he's got his head lowered to yours, so he doesn't attack. Ooh.
20 against a goblin.
A goblin hits you for 2, good sir.
My! What foes we have this day.
He is a hit against a goblin.
RD10 plus 11.
You can't not kill a goblin.
15 damage to the guy. I still like to know.
He dies.
And then my second attack, RD20 plus...
The wolf misses the goblin with his bite.
22.
Crit, doesn't matter. Was that a goblin?
Yeah. Max damage, 21 damage to the goblin.
Okay, you like triple kill him. You should... Oh, yeah. Alright, you get one more attack, don't you?
At the very end of the round, after all other creatures have gone.
They went at the same... You all went at the same time.
Okay. I will attack the goblin that's holding the chain of the wolf that I wounded.
Yeah.
18.
It's a hit. And dead.
And dead.
So this wolf turns and flees. You can grab an attack of opportunity if you want.
I let him flee.
This goblin and wolf pair flee, and the wolf sort of after the goblin.
I look at the other two goblins. Cross my arms. Nodachi's pointing. Nodachi's pointing behind me and kind of up behind my arms.
Chad is asking about cleavage. There is no cleavage in second edition, aside from all the sexy pictures in the Monstrous Manual.
Yeah. I've been allowing the roleplay party some like optional attacks where you can cleave and like go through multiple monsters if you attack with this penalty and then they kill them and then you attack with
Introduced
this.
Introduced that in third edition. It's not in the second edition core.
Yeah, of course not.
Combat attraction. Combat.
Yeah. I don't expect it to exist.
Those rules, guys. Come on.
Okay. I was explaining for your edification, not as an excuse to get it in.
Yeah. So, do you want to roll initiative?
Oh, yeah, totally. I'm going to step up to those goblins and ruin their day.
Okay.
17.
You go last, but they're holding their actions. This goblin actually flees towards this gate. The wolf bites this goblin, but they're both still alive. This goblin holds his ground. You notice he is wielding a battle axe. Two-handed, because he's small. And this wolf is sort of circling, but he looks too afraid to approach. So this guy's action is held, but your initiative round pops up.
4 from Mod's Dialect Epic. Dicing with Death bends bars and breaks the system. Bends the bar and breaks the system. Yeah. All right. I take a half move. To this guy. And attack him if he's not.
He attacks you first as you approach. Uh-oh, good sir. What's your HP at?
My HP's at 4.
You didn't. I think you forgot to take damage. I'll let it stay that way.
No. You did 4 damage to me, and then 2 damage to me.
Okay, you're right. All right, you take 3 damage from this battle axe. That's D8, right? It wasn't right. 4.
No, it's D8.
Okay. So he swings the battle axe double-handed. All right, you go.
Roll 14, hit him.
No. Oh, yes, sorry. Yeah.
Yeah.
6, so 14. AC 14 in the new system.
Roll minimum damage of 12.
Minimum damage of 12.
SCG Nightmare throws a gold coin in the arena.
Still conscious.
What?
The greatest goblin you've ever seen. But you still felled the goblin leader in one hit. The crowd screams, and from the box you hear the booming voice that could only emanate from a 25-foot-tall man. Finish him!
Is his hand on his weapon?
Yes. Well, I mean, he's leaning on his weapon. It's the only thing keeping him from collapsing.
My question is, if I were to try and pick him up, would he get an attack of opportunity on me?
You don't think so. You don't think he has it in him.
Okay. I would like to pick him up with both hands. Like, so I'll drop my Nodachis to the ground, grab the goblin, and lift him over my head.
Sure, roll the hit.
Or just a straight D10, right? No strength bonus to hit on a grab.
Strength bonus to hit on a grab.
Okay, absolutely. D20 plus 4 then. 15.
Yeah.
I grab him, lift him above my head.
Press?
What?
What's your max press?
840 pounds!
So you just...
I'm sorry, 810 pounds.
You lift and press the goblin above your head.
Like I go, urgh! I turn in a circle.
Put it down quick, otherwise encumbrance rules will apply.
Oh no! I turn in a circle, growling, and then the encumbrance rules apply, and he falls onto my horns! I pull him into my horns.
Okay, roll 2d6 for overkill damage. Plus strength bonus.
2d6 plus 11. Or 10, 9, I'm sorry.
Okay.
Oh, almost minimum damage. 12 damage to the goblin as I impale him on my horns. He
dies on your horns. Impaled. A glorious roar arises from the crowd. This guy over here is skewered on a spike. Skewered on a pike from between the bars. This wolf is here. This goblin and this wolf are still fighting, but no one gives a shit. And you gain experience.
Like 10. No. Each goblin gives 7. A wolf gives, like, what, 15?
120.
120 experience points.
They're 3 hit die creatures. And you defeated 3 of them, technically. So you get 360 plus... Goblins only give 7? I thought it was 15.
It's 7 or 15. Goblins
15. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, let's call it 10, 150... That's 360, 470 experience times 10%.
470 plus 47 is 514.
All right, the crowd cheers you and showers you with baguettes.
My head starts to get a little strained from having to hold the whole goblin over my head. And so mm-hmm. then I kind of play it off. As if I'm tossing him to the ground. Just like,
all right, you toss my horns. All right.
How tall is the...
Who's doing these pictures?
How tall is the wall of the arena?
About 25 feet tall.
Dude, I like this one of the Minotaur with the 2 Nodachis cutting a goblin in half.
Yeah.
At the same time. It's fucking sick.
Yeah. Damn. Talented chat. Was that...
Muy talented.
Was that Leafton? Leafington? Did he draw that or did he just post it? I don't know. Anyways.
Wait, so how tall was the wall around the
30 feet.
30 feet up to the first set of stands?
Yeah.
Seriously? That's huge. That's like a two-story house.
Yeah.
I'm completely surrounded by two-story houses. All right.
It's stone walls. Yeah. There are cracks. If you were a thief, you think you could climb it, but you're not.
That's cool. I'm down.
Oh, the bears will come. Don't you worry, Christopher M. Robinson. The bears will come. Assuming Neil doesn't foil all of my plans.
I retrieve my Nodachis. Would it be typical for the arena to resupply me with darts, or do I have to go pick up my own darts?
You'll be resupplied and cared for.
All right. And then I proceed to walk down back into my house.
Okay, waiting for you at the tip of the stairs are two pikemen as well as a priest battle.
I look at the priest and say, do it.
Come, let me tend to you.
I know, right now. Let's go.
Okay. He starts dressing your wounds, stops bleeding, yada, yada, yada. Touches you and casts a spell. You gain 3 HP.
Measly 3 HP.
About a minute. He gestures for you to continue back down.
Okay. I look at the guard. I growl at the guards if they, try and even pretend like they're escorting me.
Okay, they keep their distance. And they bring you to this room, which does not have a bar. It just has a wooden door.
Oh, no. I can bend bars, but wooden doors. I can't get through the wooden doors.
You can only bend bars once. You can open doors as many times as you want. But it doesn't look like as much of a cell. It's more of a room. It's got plushy cushions and a wash basin.
Okay.
Priest comes inside with you. The guards wait outside.
Okay.
He's some sort of battle priest. And he heals you for another 2. Are you not at full?
No, I will be. I'm down 4 still.
Okay. He tells you that's all he can do for you today, and he'll get a good night's sleep, and he'll check on you in the morning.
Thank you, battle priest. Your god will be happy with your work.
He says, fought well today, champion.
I shall fight well every day.
Every day? Are you ready to honor the god of battle tomorrow?
I am ready to honor the god of battle every day.
He said, then perhaps I will offer you a blessing. And he turns and leaves. Do you rest up and sleep the night?
Is this like, I thought there would be someone else in this room. Is it just a nice?
It's just you. You figure since you broke your last room, they gave you a new room.
I go check to make sure the door is not locked.
They don't actually lock you in.
Sweet. Okay. Are the guards still outside?
You open the door.
Yeah.
They are not outside. There's one pikeman leaning against the wall there.
I point at him with one of my Nodachis. You! Pikeman, come here! I have need to speak with you.
He takes a step forward, but he does not step within range.
Okay. Bring me a wench! And then I turn around and go back into my room.
Says they're already on the way.
Excellent!
Would you like a cow or a woman?
I drop my Nodachis and turn around and walk towards him. I at double pace.
He quivers in his boots. Chat, decide for me his reaction. Last time he failed to save versus something or other and pissed his pants. Please no. Bend the wench. The name of the town is Raquan. The war god is not Raquan. This isn't Raquan in your world, is it, Neil? Or am I writing the lore as we go?
I don't know. We'll see.
He shits himself. He drops his pike and he shits himself. You see the room fills with the stench of his bowels.
I push him, or grab him by one hand, push him up against the wall.
I was just trying to be courteous, my lord.
next time it's your wife. And I toss him to the ground and walk back into my room.
Have you seen this picture of, like, Amish JP? Zircon, where did that come from? Okay. Sorry, what did you say to the guard?
I pick him up, push him against the wall, growl in his face. You notice, next time it's your wife.
You notice that he has a bulging fear boner sticking out of his chain pants.
Okay. I look down at it, grab it in my hand, and say, she won't be needing you very much longer if you keep displeasing me. Give it a nice tight squeeze enough to cause any man extraordinary amounts of pain.
Roll a willpower, willpower check.
Oh, God. Oh, no. Did I break his penis? D20 plus 8, 21 or higher, 11.
You accidentally squeeze too hard and you feel something pop beneath the chainmail.
I guess she doesn't have need of you now.
He starts crying.
Bring her to me now. In addition to the wenches. And I drop him and go back into my room.
You're a sicko.
Okay, he runs, leaving his pike behind. At about that time, another guard comes with two women. Do we need detailed descriptions and to roleplay this encounter, or should we just fast forward?
No, he has his way.
Okay.
Does the guard ever bring his wife?
No. What? You never see that guard again.
Okay. I don't care.
Okay. Alright. So you have two women who can barely handle you. Actually, I've heard that bulls have surprisingly small penises.
I bet no one's ever told him that to his face.
This is out of character, whatever, or out of game. Anyways, moving on.
No, okay, chat, we need to make a distinction here. This is Gruff or Maverick, who is a sicko and who is a terrible person. Neil is a quite nice person. You've seen Neil play Rich, you've seen Neil play Solomon, all sorts of things. The character is evil and awful. It's not me. I have no desire to grab another man's penis and crush it, nor to force myself upon his wife. Just a quick... Let's differentiate between player and character here, guys. We're smart enough to do that.
Okay. Well, this got weird. Okay, we're done with the weird.
Good.
You sleep all that night on a plushy bed with your wenches, and you rise in the morning. If you were tended by a healer, you'd still don't gain HP if you had strenuous activity, correct?
Absolutely not.
Okay. All right. The next morning, you awaken to find the woman gone. And do you wish to do anything, or do you at your own pace?
No, I doze and chill out until it's my time to battle.
All right. The priest comes and visits you again. And heals you one more time. Ouch for one. What is your HP at?
Seven. Down by three.
Alright. He asks if you are ready to fight again today, or if you would like another day's rest.
I will fight today.
Very brave, my lord. I think we have a special treat in store for you.
Who am I destroying?
Seems you will be wrestling the great brave ogre.
Wrestling?
Billy Bob.
Ogre?
Okay.
I need oil.
If it pleases you, sir... And he goes,
my hide is thick. It takes much oil to get me into the proper glow and glisten of a wrestler's form.
Okay, he leaves and comes back a few minutes with a big, water skin full of olive oil.
Okay. If we're wrestling, I oil myself up.
Okay. Right. He says, I will now bless you for combat.
I kneel before him. Vaguely.
Cast a bless spell on you. Let's clear the battlefield. So you do you put on you take off your armor and oil yourself up?
Yeah, we're wrestling, he said.
Okay, yeah, sure.
Yeah, that's I walk into the
say fuck the wrestling. I'm gonna. Okay.
I mean, if he said wrestle, I assume we're both wrestling. So I walk up there wearing nothing but my fur and the oil that I rubbed into it.
Okay.
He's a minotaur. Of course he's covered in fur.
All right. So you surface on this end of the arena. Free hand. Actually, I heard my objects and token. Free hand. What color should this ogre be? We'll make him blue. Damn it.
Oil me, Jenkins.
I assume you oiled yourself, right?
Oh, absolutely. Insane. There's nothing gay about two grown men oiled up and wrestling each other. That's how the Greeks did it.
Turkish oil wrestling shit.
I haven't seen it, but that's that. It's there's nothing gay perfect. About that. There's it's combat. It's manly.
All right. So your opponent enters the gate across from you.
What is that? What is that below him?
I don't know.
Are those balls? Ryan, did you draw him dragging balls across the floor?
It's his it's a hook. It's his hook. So he's unarmored and naked as well, wearing like one of those sumo wrestler get-ups.
Right.
He has some sort of hook in his hand. You can roll an intel check for me.
Why is the hook on the ground and nowhere near his hand?
roll an intel check for me.
I am very confused by the. All right, which subset of intel do you need? Do you need because I split my intel.
I don't give a shit.
Well, they're very different.
It's a knowledge check. I don't know what the intel things are.
I'm checking.
One of them is called memory, isn't it? Memory and knowledge. Is that what they are?
It is reason and knowledge.
All right, so roll. Yeah, either actually. I don't care. Whichever's higher.
Okay. D20 plus 12. D20 plus 12. One. I rolled a one.
You have no idea why he's carrying this hook, but he immediately discards it as soon as he sees you.
Okay.
And he starts strutting towards you. Puts his arms up and gets the crowd cheering. And he grunts something at you in ogre. Do you speak ogre?
No. I only speak common.
Okay. So he flexes his muscles and struts to the center of the arena. What do you wish to do?
I stamp my feet, and I want to roll for initiative.
All right. Roll, sir.
7, lowest possible initiative. Yes.
You go first.
Okay. I lower my head and I charge him with my horns.
All right, roll the hit.
RD 20 plus 4. 15.
That's a hit. Do ogres have natural AC of 5, or is that if they're armored?
I think it's natural AC 5.
Okay.
Yeah. R2D 6 plus 9. 13 damage to the ogre as I gouge him with my horns.
A gasp of surprise. You skewer him on his on your horns. How much damage?
13. Wait, Minotaurs, they get plus 4 to their HP.
Plus 1. Okay, no, plus 1 to their HP. Okay, you knock all the wind out of him. His entrails are hanging out on the top of your head like a nice sexy hat. And he's barely alive. Okay. He tries to free himself from you. Do you let him?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
Okay, he pulls himself off of you and drops to his knees.
I start walking circles around him.
He starts speaking to you quietly in whatchamacallit, in ogre, but you said you didn't speak that, correct?
Right.
All right, he's trying to put his entrails back inside of his gut.
I ignore him and walk circles around him at a pace of like 10 feet out from him, flexing and roaring at the crowd.
Chat throws baguettes at you. crowd cheers. Cheater Neil.
Yeah.
What do you wish to do? You hear the crowd's roaring loudly, but there's no word from the podium.
After two circuits around him, I squat down behind him and put my hand on his shoulder, and I whisper quietly, "Do you want a clean death?"
Finish it.
I go to the snap the neck.
Alrighty. Roll a Ben Barrs.
2 No, that's almost the best I can succeed by.
You accidentally tear his head off. Crowd action.
I roll with it as if it was what I meant to do, and I chuck it into the crowd.
Baguettes for everyone. That's so funny.
I'm pasting it to you in Skype.
Okay. Alright. Okay. Blood for the blood god.
Do you see what I posted in Skype?
Sorry, my browser's fucking up. You hear a shout from the disembodied voice in the in this box, whatever, saying, "That was too easy." And you hear the clanking of chains and the creaking of metal.
Okay. I throw up my arms and I say, "Then bring me a fair fight."
Well, that's the that's that Turkish mud or oil wrestling I was talking to you about.
Okay.
And one of the common maneuvers is to try and get your hand down your opponent's pants so that you can get a grip on like their belt or whatever, and then you throw them by sticking your hand down their pants.
Whatever. A man's got to do what a man's got to do to win a fight.
All right. Okay, actually, so, a pikeman runs up from your gate
and armor.
Okay.
And I yell at him, "I need chalk for my hands. Bring me chalk."
Okay, this gate is creaking open.
I start putting on my armor.
Yes, sir. And he runs back down here.
Okay.
So you put on your weapons and armor.
Yeah, and I chalk the shit out of my hands before I pick up my weapons.
Chat, show me some bears.
Mm.
See, where are those bears? Your chat? Or
no, they're Ryan's chat. Other Ryan.
Okay.
It's very unfortunate we have two Ryans playing D&D.
Yeah, you can just call me Hobgoblin.
Yeah, I usually just call you Hob.
Drink blood or riot. I'm not seeing any bears. The battle won't start until I see some bears.
45 seconds delay, dude.
Oh, 45 seconds.
Yeah, it's bullshit, but it's how Twitch works these days. There's the bears. Oh, wow, Logan's got a fucking sick bear.
Oh, what's that? That's like a werewolf or something. There's no werewolf, just a bear. So the you're getting your armor on. How long does it take?
Technically speaking, it's one round for every point of AC, so it should take 6 rounds to put the armor on.
Okay. So you're 2 rounds in when the gate opens, and you see emerging from... Let's see if I can find a token. How do I search for that?
Just go to the token area and search bear.
Bearskin rugs. There we go. Buy on Marketplace. Fuck that.
Yeah. You should be able to scroll down and find some. There you go.
So a bear pops out of this. He's still on a chain. 3 minutes in, and the chain's released. And the bear starts circling.
Okay, so that means I've had 3 rounds to put on my armor?
Yeah, so you're halfway there.
Okay. So
it roars and rears onto its hind legs. It stands almost as tall as you.
Okay. I want to keep putting on my armor mm-hmm. until I feel like the bear is, you know, actually going to come up and attack me. Like, until I have to roll for initiative, I want to keep
it's circling and sniffing.
Alright, I keep putting on my armor until it gets aggressive.
You're able to finish putting on your armor.
Sweet.
Circle all the way over to there.
Did I get chalk for my hands ever?
Yeah, sure. At some point.
Cool.
He popped out, but he just ran in, saw the bear, threw it there. So the chalk's over that way.
Okay. Fuck it. I just grab some sand off the ground instead and sand up my hands, get the oil off, grab my dual Nodachis, and roll for initiative to attack the bear.
All right, let's do this.
Are you sure you want me to fight a large creature? A size large creature?
Uh-oh. Okay.
Plus 8. 11.
11?
11.
It's the AC for a size large, or the initiative for a size large?
6.
6? All right, you go first.
I walk up towards the bear. I swing my 2 Nodachis at it.
Move your character up to the bear and roll the hit. Twice.
13. 17.
Shit, both are hits.
2d20 plus 22.
2d...
Because it's a d20
oh
plus...
Oh my god.
43 damage to the bear! Bear smash!
Alright. The bear dies. You hear the crowd roar. And you hear a creaking from behind you.
I turn to face it. Bring me a worthy opponent!
Okay. So actually, both of these gates are creaking. And about a minute later, from each of them, pops another bear. Roll initiative.
Seventeen.
Okay. This bear charges you.
Is this one going to actually put up a fight? Last one barely did.
It hits you with both claws for 2 damage.
I'm a little bit of a glass cannon here.
Yeah, we'll need to level you up. Alright, 2 damage.
Pretty sure I'm about to.
Alright, this one is not engaging yet.
Okay. I will swing my... Oh, that took a minute, so this is technically a new... Alright, so I get 2 attacks this round. RD20 plus 5. 14 against the bear.
That is a hit.
RD20 plus 11 for damage. 24 damage to the bear.
24 will one-shot the bear. Initiative? Or is that only one attack?
That's one attack.
Do you wish to move to this bear and make your second attack?
Can I move that far and make my second attack?
Yeah, that's only 75 feet. Yeah, that's less than half your movement, right? Can you move 120 and attack?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
No, I can move it. Half an attack. I can move 120 at normal speed, or I could move 60
sure.
and attack.
Sure. It's 60. It's fine. I don't care.
Okay.
Make your attack.
17.
That'll do it.
18 damage. Oh, so light. So light.
18. All right, you finish the bear before he gets to attack. He was holding his attacks or whatever, but... dead.
I stab my swords into the ground, grab the bear by his pelt, and mm-hmm. lift him above my head for a moment and shake him. And then toss him down.
Hold on a second. What's your max?
810 pounds, baby.
I think you can probably do it, but I need to check.
See, chat, these are completely 100% legal characters you can build
if you really want to. If your DM lets you use the weird races and the...
It's allowed in the books. There's rules for it specifically.
Yeah.
If you want to hack the system, this is how you hack the system.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I think the largest ever is 900 pounds.
Yeah.
All right. So you push this, you press this 300 pounds.
Slam him down in front of me.
I think grizzly or polar bear would be more than 800 pounds.
Probably.
Bears do not weigh more than 810 pounds. I just Wikipedia'd it. A black bear, the highest recorded ever was 900. Average is probably around 300 to 400 to 500 for a large male.
Mm-hmm.
Alrighty. So the crowd's cheering. Have you taken damage today?
I took 2 damage.
From a bear? Yeah.
Yeah, from a bear.
Release the Kraken. Well, yeah. That'll be it for today.
All right. I show off a little bit more, and then I go back down to my area.
All right. You gain 525. What did we fight first? Oh, plus the ogre. Do you know what an ogre is? 270?
270, normally.
All right.
Six hundred total.
All right, 800 XP total.
800 plus 80. Wait, 800 times 0.10 or 1.1, right? For prime requisites.
Yeah.
So 80 plus 514. I'm at 1394. It's not quite leveled.
All right. We'll level you up tomorrow.
All right.
You want to do a commercial break while I go to the bathroom?
Yeah, yeah. Let's take our first commercial break in 2.5 hours, and we'll see you guys soon.
Oh. What are you doing?
No. Hi, how are you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you doing?
I'm bored.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm wearing my pajamas.
That's nice.
Mm-hmm. We haven't gone out at all today. It's kind of disgusting. How are you, like, holding up?
Easy peasy lemon squeezy. It's only been 47 hours of streaming, so I've only been awake for, like, 52 hours.
Wait, so when did you wake up in relation to when you started your stream?
I started streaming at, like, 5:30. I woke up at like noon, but I didn't actually like roll out of bed until like 2, so 3 extra hours. So it's been like 50 hours, 50 some hours a week.
Wow.
It's not that much, actually. Like,
I've gone to sleep twice since you woke up.
Yeah, most people have.
Wow, well, you're almost there. You're like more
no,
than halfway.
No, I'm just barely over halfway. I have to do this whole thing again.
How much have you made?
5,521 plus ad revenue.
And then you get to keep it all?
Is there taxing? It gets taxed by the government at some point, and PayPal takes 3 cents plus, no, 3% plus 3 cents of every transaction.
Okay. Wow. You still end up
with donations?
Yeah, I mean, it's only that big of a deal for things that are like a dollar, because then PayPal ends up taking like over a third of it.
Right.
But when you have things that are like, you know, $100 and it's like $3 here, $3 there, it's not that big of a hit.
Okay. So overall, you're still going to be able to like pay rent for the next year.
Not for the next year. Rent in San Francisco is not cheap, but yeah, this should do me well for rent for the month.
Good. Wow.
You're on stream, dear.
Ryan's
back. I actually took the camera off and put it on an overlay so I could play with Skype stuff. She is not on stream. She is still hidden from the world unless you would like her to be shown. Or I guess more likely if she wants to be shown.
She doesn't know it's good for her.
We're still live. The audio is still piped to the rest of the world.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alrighty.
Is this my glass?
Yeah. You need more HP. Accept Bitcoin. It's an interesting suggestion.
All right, are you ready?
Yeah.
All right, well, we're back whenever you're ready.
Sure. Okay. Oh, shit, you totally forgot that blast, dude.
Oh, plus one to hit on all those things. Whoops.
I think you hit every time you tried, but...
Yeah.
I made that three can, but he hasn't popped in yet. But I think he will fight soon. Alrighty. So you oil wrestled an ogre. Actually, you speared him before the battle even started. And you killed three brown bears. And the day ends, and you head back to your room. The priest shows up. Actually, he doesn't show up. Your girlfriends are brought to you, and I assume you go to sleep. Actually, the priest does show up, and he tends to your wounds, but he doesn't heal you.
Okay. Chat demands you accept Bitcoin and Dogecoin. If PayPal does it automatically, then awesome. If not, then no.
I don't think okay. Yes, you do get XP for penis pop. I just rounded it in to what I gave you.
Yeah, it's insufficient. So
you get like 15 XP for killing a, or for defeating a first level penis pop or whatever. First level, zero level fighter, whatever he was.
Yeah.
Okay. So you go to bed, I assume?
Yeah, totally. Go to bed.
All right. Chill out. Next spring, priest comes and visits you. Heals you once for five.
Ooh. Are you full? That puts me at full.
Okay. And then he does not heal you again.
Thank you, battle priest.
Well.
You would be a valued friend on the field of honor. Should you ever need a warrior to stand by your side, I ask you call upon me, and we shall meet death, or deal out death to others together as brothers.
I am honored, brave warrior, but the offerings you make to the blood god in the arena are more than enough for the time being. Okay. So...
Yeah. You must look beyond what is satisfactory to achieve greatness, my brethren. I encourage you to pick up your mace and fight foe.
I do when the need arises. Prepare yourself. Today will be a hectic battle.
I shall defeat all my enemies.
Okay.
All right.
So, you are ushered into the arena by a pikeman, not the one that you crushed his balls. You haven't seen him since.
Okay.
He says, "Come, your enemies await."
I shall crush them. I walk. Boop, 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 boop.
All right.
Oh my god. What are these?
Crowded into the arena. Oops, that's too many. Actually, there's only 12 of them. All right. At each gate, standing in front of each gate are four 6.5 foot tall, orange-skinned humanoids dressed in thick hides with a shield and blade. You recognize them to be hobgoblins.
They cannot defeat me with strength, so they try to defeat me with numbers.
Bring their swords against their shield.
I sheathe my no-dot cheese.
Roll a perception check. You sheathe your no-dot cheese.
Yeah, I fucking dart at this one all the way through.
Okay. Roll a perception check.
I think my perception is 11. 28.
All right. You notice that this gate is open.
Okay.
Okay. All right. You hear from the press box, "Charge!" And simultaneously, the hobgoblins start to run at you. Or what do you want? What do you want to do?
I want to declare a heroic fray with my no-dot cheese and destroy everything in my path.
You cannot do that.
Oh, because they're not hit-die difference?
Yeah.
Fuck. Okay.
We can do a battle with Kobold if you want.
No. Let's see. I get an extra plus one to hit with my... damage is enough. I think the extra attack every round is going to be worth the penalty of one to hit. So I sheath my no-dot cheese, I pull out darts, and I throw them at my enemies as they approach.
Alright, do you wait till they get in close range?
No, I will throw as quickly as I can. If that means catching them at long range, I will throw at long range.
Okay. Let's roll initiative. Let's go ahead and roll. It doesn't matter, because you're going to get your first attack.
9.
Oh, let me think for a second. Let me do measurements. Can't. Speed 9. Do you wish to step forward and approach them, or what?
I wish to throw my darts at them as soon as quick possible.
So that's 10, 20, 30, which is what?
10, 20, 30 yards.
Okay, so they are at long range at the end of the round. Unless you wish to move towards them.
No, I will... Even the ones on my sides are long?
What's that?
Even the guys on my sides are...
Just where they end up. They're going to be... Yeah, those are long range.
Okay. I will accept the long range and throw at minus 5 to hit.
Okay. So take your attacks.
D20 minus 1. 3. 17. And 1.
3, 17, 1.
Uh-huh.
The 17 hits.
D3 plus 11 damage. 13 damage to a hobgoblin.
Plus 11 damage on him? That's absurd.
I know!
You fall this hobgoblin. And you see emerging from this pit is the four-armed praying mantis man that you saw before.
Ho, brother! Let us destroy these beasts!
Alright, roll initiative.
Ten. Oh, shit. I should not have had all of these delicious pineapples. The sugar crash is killing me. It's a 10. Bad idea.
How much caffeine have you been having?
Almost nothing.
Crazy.
I had one monster all last night, and then one cup of tea the night before.
Okay. So, in each of this praying mantis's arms is a spear. And he charges to the back, or runs to the back of these hobgoblins over here, and unleashes a flurry of blows. Actually fucking it up pretty badly. He gets plus one for strength, plus one for specialization is plus two. Alright. Plus two. Hobgoblin, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright. Felling one hobgoblin. These three turn to engage him while the others continue to run at you. What was your initiative? Sorry?
10.
All right, you go at the same time. So you can get. Okay, you'll get one attack, and then you will get second attack at the end of the round.
Are they still at long, or is this point at medium?
You can take the first attack at medium, second attack at the end.
Okay, plus four, minus, what is that, minus two for medium? So d20 plus, minus, plus two to hit. Five, blah.
Yes. Alright, two of the hobgoblins close and miss. And end of the round. Extra attacks.
Once I got to take off the sweater.
Alright, none of the hobgoblins managed to hit the Threakin.
Alright, extra attack. How many hobgoblins have closed with me?
Two are within melee range. The rest are pretty close.
No, I will forego my final attack and instead draw weapons.
Draw your nano cheese?
Yeah.
All right, initiative.
Sixteen.
Wow. All right. Oh, shit. My character is badass. So I get plus two to initiative, I think. Maybe even plus three. Yeah, plus two to initiative. Didn't even realize that. Either way, I go first. And then the hobgoblins, and then you. Four. A flurry of, okay, so first attack. Hobgoblins aren't large, are they?
No.
What's my... Plus three, so that's six. A hobgoblin. Another. And a third. Okay. This is why they nerfed dual wielding in third edition. So I take out all three of these hobgoblins. I mean, this NPC. hobgoblins go... The two adjacent to you attack and miss. Two more approach. Missing, one critical misses. And accidentally stabs a friend.
Ouch.
So this hobgoblin stabs this hobgoblin. Okay, your turn.
I take my dough cheese and I roll the hit.
We'll go.
10.
10 to hit?
Yeah.
That is a miss.
Natural 1. 18, though. Pass on the save.
Natural 1.
Yeah.
Ouch. You get your... Oh, no, you don't get a second attack this round.
That was my second attack this round.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Threakin runs forward and then takes a medium range shot with his spear for his end of run attack. I don't know if that's legal, but he's doing it anyways. And a miss.
Okay.
All right. Next round, roll initiative. Crashing over there?
Yeah. All of a sudden, a wave just hit me, and I'm just Tired, really tired. 16.
Slow.
Very.
All right. 4 hobgoblins attack you. What's your AC?
16. 4.
1 hits for 4 damage.
Okay.
You can go while I resolve the Threekin's combat with goblins. Hobgoblins.
Attack for 10.
Oh, wait.
Hold on. I was just trying to figure some stuff out. I have 3 attacks this round. So 10, 8... and 17 is a hit.
Alrighty. 10, 8, yes. 17 is the only hit.
Yep. I do 19 damage to him.
19 damage will kill a hobgoblin. There are 3 next to you. 2 next to the Threekin. Next round, roll initiative. Actually, sorry. Let's get another attack.
15. Let me see if I can to move some dishes in the kitchen. Hopefully that'll help clear my head.
Yeah.
Be right back.
I don't know. What's up, chat? What would happen if Neil took a 1-minute nap? Wouldn't he lose? Baguettes. My character looks like. Threekins are humanoid praying mantises. I think they're in the Monster's Manual, so I'll go ahead and turn to you there. They have 6 limbs, so 2 arms, 2 legs, and 2 in between that sort of act like either chopping. I think that's my girlfriend chopping. Are you making onions or something? Forging onions?
Forging onions.
Are you chopping onions?
Yeah.
That's onions being chopped. I think someone even posted a link to Threekins. I was gonna. Yeah, see that link. That's a Threekin. Intelligent mantis warriors. I think they stand. Wow. Oh, supposedly they're size large. Although in the Monster's Manual they were not, or in the. Or in the skills and powers, they were not considered size large. Am I size large? No, I'm not size large. Mantis warriors. Onions of -2 perception. Always never admit that I'm not large. Yeah, I think if you allowed Neil mini naps, he could bust some like polyphasic sleep and ruin everything. I love you, Snoopy Kitty. A developer? I don't know what a developer is. I'm not like a game developer or a computer programmer.
Woo! Who knew waterboarding yourself would be so awakening?
Waterboarding yourself?
Big bowl full of water, shove your face in it until you It's surprising how much of an effect cold water will have on your face when your face is entirely submerged on it. And the rest of your body's like inland.
I love cold showers.
Yeah, but I was pouring water on my face before. There's a different sensation between having like cold water on your face and having your face submerged just like this much in water. Like a psychosomatic response.
Did you go to the bathroom and turn the faucet on or something? Or?
I've been sticking my head under the sink every few hours.
Sink.
Yeah. Well, I forgot my glasses somewhere.
Okay, I'll continue chatting with chat. Taylor Black.
Whew. All right, cool. So what's going on? We're killing hobgoblins now?
Yeah, we're killing hobgoblins.
All right. Let's kill some hobgoblins.
Grad student in engineering. A sciencer, as the case may be.
You found a fellow sciencer in chat?
No, someone was asking what my career was.
Oh.
And I guess the answer is I don't have a career. I'm a lifelong student, and they can't make me leave.
That's the dream, isn't it?
What's that?
That's the dream, right?
Something like that.
They can't ever kick you out?
A rolling initiative.
That's right. Rolling initiative is what we were doing. D10 plus 8. Ooh, 2, 10.
Let's do this. You actually go before the hobgoblins this round. 10, you said?
10. I rolled a 2 and an 8. 2 and plus 8 is 10, as far as my math is concerned. My maths is 10, concerned.
You actually go the same time as the Threakin.
Bring it on, Threakin, buddy.
Okay, so attack some hobgoblins.
RD 20 plus 5. 13?
Is a miss.
8? And last attack, 17.
17 will hit.
I kill 12 damage.
Alright, that's two fell a hobgoblin. If I can ever erase these guys. Do you get an extra attack this round, or was that?
That was my extra attack this round.
Oh, okay. You should have saved that till the end, but I don't really care.
Oh, sorry.
Because both the hobgoblins miss. And they make a serious morale check. And fail, and fall to their knees.
Cowardly hobgoblins.
All right. The Threakin walks up behind them and they die. 3 hits for 9, 9, and 7 damage. Yeah, that's enough to kill all the hobgoblins.
Brother! I have not seen you in some time!
It's been like 2 days. You've got a hobgoblin stuck on you. You can help move it off, but I can't. Okay. I kind of liked it. All right. And you hear the gates creaking. These 3 gates creaking.
2 arms, brother. I fear they said more for us.
All right.
To the center.
I back to the center. My back against his butt.
All right.
Let's see.
There are any small creatures other than kobolds so that we can declare a heroic fray?
I think Tyrosi are...
Tyrosi? I guess even goblins would work, but...
Are they not called Tyrosi?
I don't know what that is. Let's just do kobolds.
Sweet. Heroic fray against the kobolds!
So heroic fray gives us 1 extra attack?
I do not remember. I just remember reading the rules once and being like, this is the dumbest thing in the world. Yeah, there's some... Talosi. Or Tasloi. But they're not, actually. They have a full hit die. Technically, humans are less than 1 hit die because they're D6, so you could heroic for humans.
Yeah.
Which is dumb. Brownie. We could heroic for brownies. Or mole rats.
brownies would be fun. They have magic powers, but I'll leave them out of this. We're just going to deal with kobolds.
Kobolds.
So the gates open, and 16 kobolds pour forth. Have you looked up what a Kurok Freight is?
No, I'm looking it up now. Chapter 3. It's at the end of chapter 3, isn't it? Heroic Frey. The most heroic and inspirational stories are battles about a stand of a few against many. The legend of Ronald holding the pass of Ronclavis, or Davy Crockett at the Alamo, or Tolkien's sail of the Fellowship against the orcs in Moria in Balin's tomb. These stories live forever in the imaginations of people everywhere. In Heroic Frey, the priests are fighting against hordes of individually weak monsters such as goblins, kobolds, or giant rats. Warriors facing adversaries far less skilled than themselves can double their normal attack rate.
Oh my god.
This only applies to their primary weapon. Okay. If the character is fighting with a weapon in each hand, the secondary weapon still only adds one additional attack per round. Any attacks of opportunity, the heroic character may be counted off of these additional attacks, however. Or must be counted off of these additional attacks, however. In addition, warriors gain one extra attack per round, which may be used to perform a shield punch, shield rush, unarmed punch or kick, or grab maneuver against any opponent that they threaten when they begin resolving their attacks for the round. The normal penalties for these attacks don't apply, so the shield maneuvers don't cost the warrior his AC bonus, and the unarmed maneuvers don't provoke attacks of opportunity. Characters can only engage in heroic phrase against creatures of one hit or one minus one hit die or less, or creatures whose hit dice are or levels are 10 less than the heroes. At 12th level, a fighter can declare a heroic foray against monsters up to 2 hit dice. At 13th level, a fighter can stand against 3 hit dice, and so on. The other requirement for heroic foray is numbers. The hero side must be outnumbered by the enemy for the warrior to gain his extra attacks. If there are fewer monsters left than attacks available, the excess of monsters are lost, or attacks are lost.
Okay. Giggletons, you should follow Neil. Give him your soul.
Who's Giggletons?
I don't know, someone in chat. Alright. So we get double the attacks. So doubling 3 every 2 goes to 3 every 1, does it not? Or will it be 2 and then 4? I think it should be 3 every 1.
For the main. No, it's 2 every 3. No, it is 3 every 2.
Yeah. Doubled. Wake up.
Yeah. Heroic. No, I'm thinking, yeah, you're right. It would be 3 every 1.
And you can get a kick or an unarmed. You can get a headbutt if you want.
Sure. All right, so 3 attacks with your primary weapon, then you get your offhand weapon attacks, then you get an additional hand butt or headbutt or whatever.
All right, or kick. Roll initiative.
D10 plus 8. 16. Nice and high.
All right, you go last. I guess 3 can already actions for kobolds to approach, and the kobolds all begin swarming forth. Okay. So I'm going to... I have too many attacks. So 3, let's say 4 can get to you.
Mm-hmm.
What's your AC?
16.
Mm. 4 damage. 2 of them hit you.
Shit.
Same thing on me. They can't technically critical you, though.
Nice.
Okay. None of them hit me. Let's go ahead and roll. You can go.
Okay.
So we each get 3 attacks with our main hand, and then usual with our second hand.
Right. And so 13, 17, 8.
AC 7. You rolled an 8?
Yeah.
That's not a hit.
Alright, 13 and 17 hit and kill.
Hit, and I think they've got D4 HP. There's no way either of us can not kill them with one hit.
Right.
So 1, 2, that's a hit, that's a hit, that's a crit. So your second attack was a hit. Did you make you get 3 with your primary and 1 with your offhand.
Oh, that's right, I forgot the offhand.
1, 2, 3, 4.
4 is 19. That's 2 kills.
Jesus Christ.
What? Two kills? That's half.
So I get three attacks with my prime. So I get eight attacks, right? No, three
and three.
Six attacks.
Yeah.
Five of which are hits.
Jesus.
Some of those were criticals, but I don't know if I can actually. I'm gonna have to just delete everything. So everything disappears. Alright. I'm gonna flurry of blows. How many? You got one hit?
Two of them bit me for two each, and I hit one.
You hit one? And you get a
I hit two. I hit two. I hit the one with the 17 and the 19. So I hit two out of four.
Okay. So why don't you go ahead and do. And then you get a free unarmed attack?
I don't know if that's true, because I.
Yes, it said warriors get an additional attack that can be used to kick, shield punch, or whatever.
Yeah, but wasn't that at the forfeit of something else? I mean, I'll take it if you're going to give it to me, but yeah. I have a feeling that I wasn't how it was laid out.
It wasn't clear. I mean, it wasn't obvious that it should be able to be a headbutt, but I said I would allow it. It was like a free shield punch or kick.
Yeah. Okay. So D20 plus 4. 21. I just grab one, and whatever I do to it, I do at plus 9 to damage.
Yeah, he does. Wait, what did you roll?
17 plus 4.
Oh, okay, so it's roll up. Yeah, okay. So you unarmed another. What are the holy rules of DMing? Who said that? Apparently I broke the first holy rule of DMing, and they want us to break the second.
What's the first rule of DMing?
I don't know.
First rule of DMing is always make sure you have fun.
Yeah. All right, whatever. Initiative.
Okay. RD 10 plus 8,
13. All right, they move to surround us. To attack the Minotaur. AC 16?
Yeah.
Yeah, neither hit. I'll say 6 attack me because I have higher AC. One of them hits for 2 damage. Alright, go.
1 RD 20 plus 3. No. Plus 1. No, RD 20 plus 3. Yeah. 6 is miss, 11, and 17.
17 is a hit, and 11 is a miss, unless you have other bonuses.
Perhaps flanking?
Sure.
Okay. So, 3 hits.
So you kill 3. Make an unarmed attack. Did you already do that?
No, I did not do that. RD 20 plus 4. 20.
Okay, there's one left.
Grab another one.
I hit 3 as well. That got stupid fast.
Yep.
Alright, and this guy pisses his pants. He dies.
Right.
16 kobolds. That's 7 XP. Psh. How many XP?
Cameras are gone. Whoops. Ha 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 ha. Oh, problem sticking your head underwater is that it does not last very long. Soon your face warms up.
Nice facts.
532 XP. That'll be divided by 2. What is your XP at? We aren't power leveling you fast enough.
Give me more bears.
Feed him bears.
Ah, here we go. I'm at 1394.
Okay, never mind. What was that? 532 divided by 2. 266. Plus 10%. All right. What now?
You said 266 time plus 10%?
Yeah. For the hobgoblins and the kobolds. What should Neil fight next? A demon goat named John, another god's champion, whelps, or five giants. I guess a demon goat named John is winning. Is there a fire-breathing goat somewhere in the Monster's Manual?
Not that I'm aware of.
I feel like I've heard of a fire-breathing goat, but...
Oh, a chimera has a goat's head on it, and it breathes fire. The dragon's head breathes fire, but...
Breathe fire. There is a goat under herd animal. Demon, goat, ABCDEFGA. Is it mammal herd is what it's going to be under? I don't think a goat is going to do much good. However, damn, there's no goat. There's a camel, there's cows, there's buffalo, there's antelope, there's sheep.
Okay, give me another sec. I'm going to go throw my head under some water again. Falling asleep again.
There's not a fire-breathing dwarf. Hill giants would probably bash our faces in. Shimmer maybe too. Let me see what that thing does. Satyrs do not breathe fire. What is this Monster's Manual thing? Oh,